you don't mind, I'm gonna use this microphone because I know the local group did a lot of work to put this banner up, and it's very symbolic. First off, this is a rare opportunity because I've actually visited Denver now twice in the same year. When you consider that we're now in 13 countries, 130 cities. So it's hard for me to visit a lot of the cities around the world that we have chapters in, but we came here a few months ago for the debut of the Guardian Angel documentary at the Denver Film Festival, where it was highly received. It didn't debut in New York City, although eventually aired there. It debuted right here in the Mile High City of Denver. And people came out, many of them who had never been to New York, didn't really understand what it was like in the first 13 years from 1979 to 1992. But it totally gave them a feel for the baptism of fire that we had to survive when we were considered adversarials by all. So now, it's back-to-back, belly-to-belly. I'm able to come to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Guardian Angels and bring my brand-new wife, who is Nancy Sleewahill, who is the head director of our Guardian Angel Animal Protection Division. So it's our honor, once again, to come to your city that has really rolled out the red carpet for the Guardian Angel concept. But it's interesting because up until 1992, we were treated wherever we were invited, and that included in New York City, where we were birthed in the fires of controversy, like hemorrhoids and red berets. Local officials, police, community activists, even the thugs, they pulled their resources, tried to get enough preparation H to smear on us. Hopefully we dry up and just fly away. So at that point, I had already been arrested 76 times, oftentimes for inhaling and exhaling, and had just finished a stint of doing 10 days in the Detroit House of Correction by then the mayor, King Coleman Young, who ruled with an authoritarian manner. He just didn't like the fact that I was in Detroit, which could have used the Division of Marines back there at the time, and just had me locked up for coming into the city. So having just survived 10 days in what they call D-Hop, and let me tell you, being a guy from New York, coming into an enclave of COs and inmates, who all knew I was coming there, I had an intense baptism, that's for sure, in what they call defecation education, fights, all kinds of problems. And unfortunately, it was because at that particular time in our history, even after 13 years, people just did not seem to understand who we were and what we were trying to do. The impression was that all Guardian Angels were manufactured and they were Federal Expressed out of New York City to whatever city was suggesting that they were in need. And that is not at all the concept. As you can see, there is not a New York City Guardian Angel here amongst the many that we are honoring today from the Denver chapter. And you notice, you see men and women, you see blacks, whites, Hispanics, Native Indians. Now, if you were trying for diversity, it would be hard enough. But all of this comes together naturally and has been our home since we started on February 13, 1979, when I was a night manager at Mickey D's in the Bronx, and all hell was breaking loose. Anarchy was prevailing, and luckily, people of all different backgrounds came together voluntarily to try to help make for a better city that was sliding into the abyss. That has always been the concept. Whether in a big city like Mexico City now, where there are 20 million people, or a small community of 10,000, it matters not. Wherever people dare to care, if they reach out to us, we'll provide them the mechanism to organize, the structure. But as you see up here, you see Wolf, you see Tammy, you see Apache. They're all from Colorado. They're all different in background. They all emerged as leaders. But it took the catalyst to come in and ignite the interest so that we could actually have a functioning group. And that was Sebastian Metz. And he was our traveling warrior at the time, who really needed an asbestos suit for all the fires that he had to purge himself out of. So for instance, the Salvation Army is providing us an opportunity to honor our members and our community support that we have in police and official support here. I remember the Salvation Army was 6 months before we were invited into Denver, was hosting us in Manchester, New Hampshire. Now understand, cities are different in terms of their political nature. Denver tends to be very liberal, progressive. Manchester, New Hampshire, very conservative, very law and order. Back then, it didn't matter what your politics. They just universally hated the Guardian Angels because they didn't understand it. So Salvation Army was hosting the start of the Guardian Angels in Manchester, New Hampshire. And I sent our best road warriors, Sebastian Metz, because already local officials were giving us a hard time. They already had a heroin and a pain killer problem in terms of drugs in the streets. That's 1993. Notice, per capita per person, Manchester, New Hampshire today has the worst drug addiction problem in the nation, bar none. And that's saying a lot for a city that in no way, shape, or form can compare to the size of Denver or New York City, where I'm from, or San Francisco or Los Angeles. But they never addressed their problem because they did what a lot of communities did, which was to put window shades on their eyes, cotton balls in their ears, a zipper on their mouth, and deny that they had a problem. And generally what would play out is what I call the DID syndrome. First, the presence of the Guardian Angels, we're gonna deny there's a problem. Then we're gonna ignore them and hope they just go away. So you deny, you ignore it, and then you delay implementing any kind of a working relationship. So at that time, it was a major turnaround in 1993. Rudy Giuliani had been elected mayor of the city of New York, and he decided to no longer have conflict with the Guardian Angels locally. He said, I don't understand. Guardian Angels have been operating for 13 years. They've never created a problem. 6 Guardian Angels have been shot and killed in the line of duty. Others have been seriously injured.